Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Dafda, and in this 17th video class of DIP, we will study image sharpening special filters and its implementation in MATLAB. So in our previous two video classes, we have studied smoothing special filters, that is linear smoothing special filters, as well as non-linear smoothing or order statistic special filters. In this particular class, we will study image sharpening special filters or high pass filters for digital image processing. So let us start. So we know that image enhancement can be done in spatial domain or frequency domain. We are currently studying spatial domain techniques, in which we have already learned point processing techniques, and we are learning neighborhood processing techniques. So spatial filters can be classified as smoothing spatial filters or low pass filters, and sharpening spatial filters or high pass filters. Low pass filters can be further classified into linear filters or non-linear filters. In linear filters, we have already studied averaging filters and weighted averaging filters, and in non-linear or order statistics spatial filters, we have learned minimum, maximum and median filter. In this particular video class, we will study sharpening spatial filters or high pass filters, and in high pass filters also we will only study Laplace and linear filters. Of course, there are other varieties of sharpening spatial filters or differentiating spatial filters also, such as gradient filters, Roberts filters, Sobel operators, Previt's operator, etc. So let us start. So sharpening aims to highlight fine details in an image or enhance details that has been blurred through errors or imperfect capturing devices. So image blurring can be achieved using averaging filters, and hence sharpening can be achieved by operators that invert the averaging operators. So in mathematics, averaging is equivalent to the concept of integration, and differentiation inverts integration. Thus, sharpening spatial filters can be represented by partial derivatives. So there are many applications of sharpening spatial filters, like electronic printing, medical imaging, industrial inspection, and autonomous guidance in military systems. So as linear smoothing is based on weighted summation or integral operation on the neighborhood, the sharpening is based on derivative or gradient or finite difference. So in smoothing, we try to smooth out noise and ignore the edges, and in sharpening, we will try to enhance the edges and ignore the noise. So you can say the principal objective of sharpening is to highlight transitions in intensity or detect the edges, right? The first order partial derivative of the digital image f of xy are delta f by delta x is equal to f of x plus 1 comma y minus f of xy, and delta f by delta y is equal to f of x y plus 1 minus f of xy. Similarly, the second order partial derivative of the digital image f of xy are delta square f upon delta x square is equal to f of x plus 1 comma y plus f of x minus 1 comma y minus twice of f xy, and delta square f upon delta y square is equal to f of x y plus 1 plus f of x y minus 1 minus twice of xy. So we'll just understand these properties using one example. Consider this particular image, and we are scanning this image along this line. So you can see that there is variation in intensity from brighter to darker. In between, there comes a bright point or white dot, then again it is dark, then comes a line, then again it is dark, and then it becomes complete white. So when we are scanning the line like this along the image, it is the scan in one dimension. The line can be represented like this in terms of intensity level, that initially it is white, then slowly it becomes dark. As you can see here, it becomes dark gradually. Here it is completely dark. So you can see here it is completely dark. Then at some midpoint, there is a white dot. There is sudden increase in intensity from dark to white. So you can see here it is sudden increase from dark to white. Again it becomes dark. Then when the line comes, it becomes brighter, and again it becomes dark, and finally at this particular point it becomes complete white. So the gray level profile of this particular line can be represented like this, and these values can be written for the image strip like this. So first derivative, delta f by delta x is equal to f of x plus 1 minus fx. As we have just seen, you can see here that this is for two dimensional image f of xy. So if it is one dimensional derivative, then it will be given by f of x plus 1 minus f of x. We will not be considering y when it is one dimensional, right? So this is the same equation that you can see over here. Similarly, the second derivative can be given by f of x plus 1 plus of f of x minus 1 minus twice of fx. If you consider only x, delta square f upon delta x can be given by f of x plus 1 plus of x minus 1 minus twice of fx. Okay, let us understand this equations, how they are implemented for the first derivative and the second derivative. Let us consider this five. So the first order derivative equation is f of x plus 1 minus fx. So f of x plus 1 is 4 minus fx is This is fx, right? 5. So 4 minus 5. So it will be minus 1. So you will get here minus 1. Similarly, let us consider this 6. So f of x plus 1 is 0 over here, as you can see here, minus of fx, that is 6. So 0 minus 6 will give you minus 6. So that is your first order derivative. Consider this 3. So f of x plus 1 is 1. 1 minus 3 will give you minus 2. So here you will get minus 2. Similarly for this 7, okay, f of x plus 1 is 7. 7 minus 7 will give you 0, that is 0. So this is how you find out the first order derivative or first derivative. Now let us find the second derivative. So consider the same points. Okay, so now it is f of x plus 1 plus of f of x minus 1 minus twice of fx. Okay, so this is our f of x, right? So f of x plus 1 is 4 plus of f of x minus 1 is 5. So 4 plus 5 will give you 9 minus twice of fx. So twice of 5, that is 10. So 4 plus 5, that is 9 minus 10 will give you minus 1. Consider this 6. Okay, so f of x plus 1 is 0 plus f of x minus 1 is again 0. So that is 0 plus 0 minus twice of f of x. So minus twice of 6, that is minus 12. So 0 minus 12 will give you minus 12. Similarly here, f of x plus 1 is 1 plus of x minus 1 is 1. So 1 plus 1 minus twice of 3, that is 6. So 1 plus 1, that is 2. 2 minus 6 will give you minus 4. And for this particular point, f of x plus 1 is 7 plus of f of x minus 1 is again 7. So 7 plus 7 is 14. 14 minus twice of 7, that is 14. So 14 minus 14 will give you 0. So from this example, we can see that the second order derivative enhances fine details, that is thin line edges including noise, much more than the first order derivative. Now let us understand the properties that we just saw in the previous slide using this example. So the first derivative must be zero along flat segments, that is constant gray level. Okay, so this is the flat segment. Here also it is flat segment. You can see here also it is flat segment, that is here it is zero. Next, it is non-zero at the outset of gray level step or ramp. Okay, edges or noise. So it is non-zero at the outset of gray level ramp. Okay, so it is non-zero over here. You can see here it is non-zero when this ramp is coming. Here again, when this is coming, it is non-zero. It is non-zero over here, as well as it is also non-zero over here. It is non-zero along segments of continuing changes, that is ramp. Okay, so let us see for ramp. So this is ramp. It is non-zero for the ramp. It is minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. Right? Hence, the properties of the first derivative are like this. Let us see the properties for second derivative. The second derivative must be zero along flat segments, that is constant gray level. So here it is flat segment, it is zero. Here it is flat segment again. Here it is 0. Here again it is a flat segment. Here again it is 0. Next, it is non-zero at the outset of gray level step or ramp, edges or noise. Okay, so it is non-zero over here, as you can see here. Okay, it is non-zero over here. It is non-zero over here, as you can see here, as well as it is non-zero over here. Next, it is zero along the ramps. So you can see here, this is the ramp and it is zero along the ramp. So hence, the first order derivative and second order derivative has the properties mentioned here. Let us understand the sharpening Laplacian filter or the derivative filter. So the Laplacian operator of an image f of xy is given by delta square f is equal to delta square f upon delta x square plus delta square f upon delta y square. So you can see that delta square f upon delta x square is given by this particular equation. Similarly, delta square f upon delta y square is given by this particular equation. So when you add these two equations, you will get this equation. So this equation can be implemented using the 3 cross 3 mask that is given over here. For this mask, this is the x direction, this is the y direction, and this is f of xy. So as this is f of xy, this one is f of x plus 1 comma y, this is f of x minus 1 comma y. Similarly, this is f of x comma y minus 1, and this is f of x comma y plus 1. So when you take the constants of this equation, you can form this filter mask. For example, for f of x comma y, it is minus 4. So you can see here it is minus 4. So we will write minus 4 over here in the mask. Similarly, for other terms, okay, f of x plus 1 comma y, it is constant 1. Here also it is 1 plus 1. Here also it is plus 1. Here also it is plus 1. Plus 1. Here also it is plus 1. Plus 1 and plus 1. As we do not have these terms, we will write here 0. 0, 0 and 0. So this is how the Laplacian operator filter mask is created. So as the Laplacian filter is a linear spatial filter, we can apply it using the same mechanism of convolution, and this will produce a Laplacian image that has grayish edge lines and other discontinuities, all superimposed on a dark featureless background. Why? because we'll be only highlighting some specific details and making all the other details zero or near to zero. So the output will be darker, but if you want to recover the background features can be recovered while still preserving the sharpening effects by the Laplacian simply by adding the original image and the Laplacian images like g of xy is equal to f of xy plus of delta square f of x comma y. So let us understand this filter mask using one example. So this is our filter mask and this is the input image and this is our output image. For this input image, all the values are higher, just these two values, this 5 and this 5, are much lower. So let us apply this filter over here. Okay, you know, of course, when the filter is outside the border, you can pad the image with the neighboring values, that is 20 itself. Many a times we also pad the values by ones or zeros. Let us say I am applying my filter mask here. So the operation will be same as convolution. Okay, so let us say what will be the output for this particular point will be equal to 0 into 20, which is equal to 0, plus 1 into 20, which is equal to 20, plus 0 into 20 is again 0, plus 1 into 20 is 20, plus minus 4 into 5, that is 4 5 is 20, so it is minus 20, plus again 1 into 20 will be plus 20, plus 0 because it is 0 into 20, right? Plus of 1 into 20 will be equal to 20, plus of 0 into 20 will be equal to 0. So this will give me 60. Okay, so this 5 will become 60 in the output image, like this. Okay, let us say what will happen when the filter mask will be over this 5. Okay, so when you apply the filter mask over here, the value which will be obtained will be again same, that is 60. So this 5 will also become 60. And let us say what will happen for some other values like this. So when we are applying the filter mask over here, we'll be padding the values with the neighboring values. Let us say 20, 20, 20, and let us apply the filter mask over here. And for this particular point, okay, what you will get will be 0 plus 20 plus 0 plus 20 minus 80 plus 20 plus 0 plus 5 plus 0, which is equal to minus 15. So this 20 will become minus 15. And similarly, these values will be obtained. So you can see here in the output image, all the values have become darker and only these two values, this 60 and this 60, are highlighted or sharpened. That means the transitions in intensities are highlighted. So when you apply the Laplacian filter, this will be the output that you will be obtaining. You can see here only the transitions in intensity or edges are highlighted. And when you obtain the enhanced image, you have to add this image to the original image. Okay, this will be your sharpened image, right? So let us implement this in MATLAB. So this is the MATLAB program for high pass filtering or sharpening special filter. We are reading an color image and converting that color image into grayscale image, and we are subplotting that image in a matrix of 2 cross 2 in the first portion. Then I am defining my Laplacian filter by w is equal to 0 1 0 1 minus 4 1 0 1 0 as we just saw in the theory, and then I am filtering my image A with the Laplacian filter w by using IM filter and storing the result in I. So we know that IM filter AW filters the image A with filter W, and then I am subplotting my filtered image. So this will be only showing the borders or edges from my original image. So to obtain the sharpened image, I have to add my original image and the Laplacian filtered image I, and I will be storing it in I1 and subplotting it in third portion of the subplot. So that will be our sharpened image or Laplacian plus original image. So let us run this program and see the output. So as you can see here, this is our original image. This is the Laplacian filtered image, which you can see consists of only the borders or the variation in intensity levels. And to sharpen this particular image, I'll be adding the original image and the Laplacian filtered image, and we'll be obtaining the sharpened image like this. We can even use the inbuilt MATLAB image, that is moon.tif, for performing the high pass filtering. Let us run and see the output. So you can see here, this is our original grayscale image, and Laplacian filtered image will be consisting of the edges or the borders, and all other portion will be black. To obtain the sharpened image, I'll be adding my original image and the Laplacian filtered image, and hence obtain the sharpened image, which is the addition of Laplacian plus original image. So you can see here, now the portions on the moon which are not visible properly in the original image are highlighted nicely in this particular output image. So for performing Laplacian filtering, we can also use local Laplacian filter for fast local Laplacian filtering of an image. So I will enable this line and I'll be disabling these lines. And this will define sigma of 0.4, alpha of 0.5, and local Laplacian filter A sigma alpha filters image A with an edge aware fast local Laplacian filter. Sigma characterizes the amplitude of edges in the image and alpha controls the smoothing of details. So here we have set parameters of the filter to increase details smaller than 0.4 or sigma. So let us run and see the output using local Laplacian filter command. So you can see now this is our Laplacian filtered image, which is much sharper as compared to the original image in which some of the portions of the moon are not visible properly. Here it is visible very nicely. So that is all for this video class. Thank you very much.